What's up, Twinkle Tunes and lighting fans? Today, we're going to be upgrading the Twinkle Tunes laboratory. Check out this table. I'll show you how I did it. Cue the bumper. So I saw this killer video of this guy named Chris Mayer. I'm gonna go with Chris Mayer. I put a link to his video that kind of inspired me on what to do here and how to do this. This guy makes killer content, killer videos. He shows you how he does this entire setup of his room and his computer and his desk. And I got some inspiration and thought, man, I bet you I could do that with one of my tables that I work on down here. So let's see how close I did to copying what he did. I don't know, let me know in the comments below. I included all the stuff I used. So if you want to get some of these products, go ahead and click on those Amazon links and it'll take you right to them.
All right, let's talk about some of the materials that we're going to need. First off, we're going to use a Mean Well LRS50-5. We're going to use a good old ESP32. Pick this up for a few bucks. A breakout board for said ESP32. Pick these up for a few bucks on Amazon as well. I'll leave the links down below. These are my favorite lights. My favorite LED strip lights to use from BTF Lighting. These are WS2812Bs. These are the ones we're going to use today. I need a good old power cord we're gonna cut up. We're gonna mock everything up first, make sure it works before we mount it and make it all happen. So, first things first, we're gonna go ahead and wire up our breadboard here, our breakout board. I'm gonna go ahead and wire this up. And your ESP32 slides right in to this breakout board right here. So I'm gonna use the power. It's gonna be my hot. This is gonna be my ground, GPIO 13. That's gonna be my data. So this is all connected and hooked up. First things first, let's go ahead and take the old cable here. We're gonna cut the end of it off. Don't need that anymore. Strip this back just a little bit. Black is our hot, green is our ground, and white is our neutral. So that's what we're gonna strip back here. And if you've seen all my other videos about using ferrule connections, I'm a big fan of the ferrules. Keep my strands nice and pretty. So that's what we're gonna do here. So on here, you'll see there's an L, an N, and a ground. L is your line, N is your neutral, and your ground is your ground. So my line, my neutral, and my ground. I always like to check and test and make sure the voltage is actually outputting what it says it's gonna output. So, we've got power coming in. Let's check it. Here's our voltage positive and our negative. And it's coming up 5.06 volts. So we're actually getting 5 volts in. So that's great. So that's working. We're gonna go ahead and unplug this. So now, two separate wires here. They got your power injection that's gonna be coming here. And then you also power down here. So, course, what do I do? That's right, you guessed it. We're putting ferrules on it. Cool Klein strippers here. I just bought these. Don't know if I'm a fan of them yet, but everybody said that they were great. And well, I stripped the wire and the wire strip, so I guess they're great. Okay, perfect. There's that. So now we need power. going to our lights. We need power going to our ESP32 here. Let's go negative to negative. And our negative to negative here. Let's go our positive here. And our positive to here. Now, let's see if we get some lights. Look at that. And we're all lit up. Cool, so we know it's gonna work. Let's pull out the app and see if we've got control. And let's see, here we go, WLED. Looks like that one right there. Go here, look at that, and the colors are all working. Perfect. So we got proof of concept, everything works. It's great. So now that that works, let's get everything buttoned up, make it look nice, and then we're gonna go ahead and install the lights.
So as soon as you plug in your ESP32, it's gonna pop up this first window. You're gonna go ahead and click on your ESP32. It's gonna connect to it, hit install WLED. This will be the most current version of WLED that it's going to install. This part takes a couple minutes. I sped it up for the video. Now that you're here, go ahead and hit the next button. And it's gonna scan for your available networks. This is the network that I run everything off of. I'm gonna go ahead and enter my credentials, my passwords into it, hit connect. And now it's connecting the ESP32 and WLED to my network. Now we're gonna go ahead and hit visit device. So now I'm connected directly to the ESP32 and to WLED. I'm gonna go ahead and change a few of my network settings because I want it to have a static IP instead of a dynamic. So I'm gonna go ahead and type in here the static IP address that I want. It's 192.168.1.230. And my gateway is gonna be 192.168.1.1. Once you've done that, I'm gonna go up here and hit save and connect. Now I've gotta go into my browser and type in that IP address so I can connect directly to it. So there I am at the 230. I hit enter and now I'm connected directly to the ESP32 and WLED again. We're gonna configure a couple other things now. Let's go ahead and hit the configure. Come down here, click LED preferences. We're gonna go ahead and turn off the brightness limiter. And we're gonna change the GPIO. The GPIO that we are going to be using is actually GPIO 13. It defaults to 16. We wanna make sure we change that to 13. Go ahead and click save. We're gonna hit back, and now we have complete control of it.
So here I am. I went ahead and I'm prepping the surface with some alcohol wipes just to get all the oils and dirt off of the edge. I'm using some 3M double-sided stick tape that I got off of Amazon. I've used this on several other projects, and it works really well. I've never had a problem with it becoming unstuck from anything. And once when you put it down, it's pretty much on there for good. This is the aluminum track that I'm now attaching on here. I got this off of Amazon as well. It's the Muzata aluminum track. It comes with a diffuser already built into it. You just kind of pop it out, put your LEDs in, put the diffuser back on. I got them in the 3-foot sections. I think if I were to go back and redo it, I would get it in 6-foot sections so I could have my front piece as one piece instead of two pieces. It still looks great. I don't think anybody's going to complain. I'm the only one staring at it. But if that would be the only thing that I would go back and change was to get the 6-foot long pieces. So now in the back left corner of my table, there's space where I'm going to go ahead and put the controller and the power supply. Same thing, I've got double-sided stick tape on the back of the plexiglass that I have installed there. Just press it on there and it's going to stay on there for good. And now here is the beginning run of my LED tape, of my pixel tape that I'm going to go ahead and run here. And that sits right down in this channel. And we're going to wrap the whole table in this LED tape. Now that I've got the tape put in the channel, I'm going to go ahead and insert the diffuser track back onto the outside here so it diffuses that light a little bit and makes it look better. So here is the final product here. As you can see, that diffuser looks really good on there. I like how it sits flush on the table. Super proud of this project. Just makes the Twinkle Tunes lab look a little cooler, you know, when I come down here, the inspiration's there. And just makes me want to build some more cool stuff and put it online. So hope you guys liked it. If you guys want to see more of this, hit the like and subscribe. I'd appreciate it. And click around the outside here. Find some more videos that you guys can go in and check out and maybe learn a little bit more. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.